How will you, at the federal level, act to address local concerns about your intensification, flood mitigation, protecting the escarpment, and fighting for local agricultural enterprises?
That is a great question. So I'll start with the flood mitigation piece. That's a big piece of our platform. We want to use the tax resources that we have and make sure that we're not allowing companies to circumvent the policies that we have in place to protect the environment by finding loopholes to escape taxation, and also subsidies to fossil fuel companies are a major waste of money, we feel, that's money that could be going to help communities and Canadians reduce their expenses and to also help with adapt to climate change. That's what it's really about. We're at a stage where we have to bring flood mitigation to communities, and you know, to also address the development issues. We are committed as a federal party to protecting green space and our green belt, which is a provincial issue, but I feel very strongly about protecting that and not expanding out beyond our current borders as a community. So we would like to maintain that boundary and not grow beyond it as a party, I believe, and me personally. And I think one of the advantages that the Green Party has over the other parties is that we don't have whip votes, by which I mean the party doesn't tell our MPs how to vote on issues of local concern. We are free to represent constituents in a much more effective way, I feel. So we can listen to what the community is telling us and vote in accordance with that instead of what the party is dictating, which is what we've seen under the current government, very disciplined following the leadership of the party.
Thank you. How will you, at the federal level, act to address local concerns about our over-intensification, the flood mitigation, protecting the escarpment, and fighting for local agricultural enterprises?
This is a huge area. I totally believe that it's all something that we need to always work at a federal level, moving into provincial and then municipal, because everything drops down. It's a strategic thought process that moves from one level down to the next. With this, I believe our escarpment is slowly going away due to global warming. So the temperatures are going up about 1.5 degree every year. With that, the water is going up and therefore getting rid of our escarpment. So we have a plan in place that is going to affect that a lot with getting rid of the fossil fuels, a lot with working towards more greener and more climate saving strategies. So things such as, you know, taking out the fossil fuels, working on automotive industry and getting more e-cars and working towards that area.
Thank you. How will you, at the federal level, act to address local concerns about over-intensification, flood mitigation, mm-hmm. protecting the escarpment, and fighting for local agricultural enterprises?
Oh, what a fabulous question, because again, this is something that I'm personally very invested in. One of the things that we did when we were elected is we formed a direct partnership with the Federation of Canadian Municipalities, understanding that cities are on the front lines of so many of the issues that people face. Municipal governments are so important because it's the level of government that most individuals interact with on a daily basis. When it comes to over-intensification, that's really something that's municipal and provincial. But what I do think is important is understanding that there is one federal political party. In fact, Andrew Scheer was here in Burlington, and when asked about this, he said that what he would do is cut red tape to ensure that there's more development, right? So Burlingtonians need to be aware of that if this is an issue that matters to them. With regards to protecting the escarpment, one of my personal projects has been the Coots to Escarpment Eco Park. We've invested $600,000 in the Royal Botanical Gardens for wetlands rehabilitation. And one of the things that I've been working on over the past 4 years, and I'm hopeful if I get reelected will come into fruition, as an urban biosphere designation at the national level. This would be the first of its kind in the world, actually, to protect these really sensitive environmental areas that are in urban areas. And one of the things that makes Burlington so special is the fact that we have this wonderful city, but we're so close to rural parts, to agriculture, to green space, to our natural environment. And we know that the Coots to Escarpment Eco Park is actually the last remaining natural corridor between Lake Ontario and the escarpment. And so I've been personally very involved in trying to protect this and working very closely with all of the partners involved.